Papu, Kanna, listen here. A bag contains 6 green balls, some black and red balls. Number of black balls is as twice as the number of red balls. So number of green balls equal to 6. Number of black balls is as twice as the number of red balls. So first you have to consider let number of red balls is x. That is next one. Therefore, number of black balls is how much? Twice of red balls. So number of black balls is 2x. Understand? Suppose if you give, just you assume, let G be the green ball. Otherwise, just in one sentence you can write let G comma R and be green comma red and black balls respectively. G represents green ball, R represents red ball, B represents black ball. That means what? 6 is nothing but N of G. Instead of writing like this, you can write like this also. N of G equal to 6. Then N of R is X. N of B is 2X. N of G equal to 6. N of R equal to X. N of B equal to 2X. Therefore, N of S equal to, that is sample space, 6 plus X plus 2X, that is 6 plus 3X. These two are like terms. X plus 2X is 3X. X plus 2X is nothing but 3X. So, this is N of S. Next one, probability of getting a green ball is, thrice the probability of getting a red ball. Probability of getting a green ball is thrice the probability of getting a red ball. This is the condition they have given. Understand? Then what are they asking? Find number of black balls. Find total number of balls. So first what you have to find out? Probability of the green ball. That means let G be the event of getting a green ball. Excuse me. Green ball. So N of G is how much? N of G, green ball, how much? 6. P of G equal to 6 by, that is N of G divided by N of S. N of G is how much? 6. N of S is 6 plus 3X. Understand? Next one is, what do you want to find out? Red. Let R be the event of getting a red ball. A red ball. That means n of r is how much? N of r x. Then p of r equal to n of r divided by n of s. That is x by 6 plus 3x. So here is one answer and here is one answer. So now you can go for this condition. P of g is equal to thrice p of r. P of g is how much? Just if you want to write once again also, you can write it. P of g equal to thrice p of r. P of g is what? 6 by 6 plus 3x. 3 into x by 6 plus 3x. Isn't it? So, both the denominators are same. So, how can you write 6 equal to 3x? Why? When this 6 plus 3x, when it comes to other side, how will it come? 6 into 6 plus 3x, isn't it? That means this and this will get cancelled. So, only I said that since it is both the denominators are same, just I am leaving out. So, 6 equal to 3x, x equal to 6 by 3. 1, 3 is 3, 2, 3s are 6. That is x equal to 2. X equal to 2. Understand? But what are they asking? What are they asking? Find number of blank balls and total number of balls. Understand? Number of black balls and total number of balls. Number of black balls is what? Number of black balls equal to what? 2x. That is 2 into 2. That is 4. Next to what? Total number of balls. What is it? Total number of balls. That is total number of balls is nothing but n of s is what? Total number of balls. Total number of balls. Isn't it? So 6 plus 3x. That is 6 plus 3 into 2. 3 into 2. That is 6 plus 6. That is equal to what? 12. So total number of balls is 12. So what are the answers? Number of black balls is 4. Total number of balls is 12. Understand? Do you follow every one of you? So just actually I am giving in detail. Very easily you can write this. First one is this and these three steps. Next condition what they have given. If you don't want to find it out here separately, directly you can write the probability here and you can do the problem. Understand? If you feel that it will take long time. Understand? According to your convenience, you do it. Within the time limit, you have to complete the problem. Is it okay? Thank you.